Ready now for the fourth of the five qualifying heats in the 200-meter individual medley for men. A new Olympic record just established in the previous qualifying heat by Robin Grew of Great Britain. Pablo Morales of the United States has apparently qualified for the final, or at least has swum a time which should make it in. And now we're going to look at Steve Lundquist, gold medalist earlier in the 100-meter breaststroke. He broke the world record in that event. It was his best swim in quite some time. And in this heat, he'll be swimming between Shinji Ito of Japan, the Asian record holder in the event. And in lane five, on the other side of Lundquist, closest to you, will be Andrew Phillips, 22 years old from Jamaica, with a real good seed time coming in of 2:05.82. And Phillips has a chance to become the first swimmer ever from the island of Jamaica to make it to the finals in an Olympic swimming event. But the focus is on Lundquist, 23 years old from Jonesboro, Georgia, Southern Methodist University, former world record holder in this event. In fact, he really emerged as a public figure in swimming at the United States National Swimming Championships back in 1978, when he broke the world record in this event and began to establish his reputation there. They swim 50 yards of butterfly, or 50 meters, I should say, of butterfly, and then backstroke, breaststroke, and freestyle.
Lundquist is quite strong in this event, but in the second half of the event, in the breaststroke and the freestyle legs, and if he can get through the butterfly here with a reasonable time, he should be in a shotgun position to not only make the finals, but possibly in the evening have a chance at Bauman of Canada and give him a race.
It will be interesting to see Bauman and Lundquist square off if Steve can qualify fast enough to be close to Bauman in the pool as they come back toward the wall at 75 meters. Shinji Ito of Japan holds the lead, and now Andrew Phillips of Jamaica, for whom the backstroke is the strongest stroke, is moving into the lead. Lundquist, however, having swum the butterfly and the backstroke, his two weakest strokes, is right between them in good shape, and he should take command now in the breaststroke. Remember, he's the world record holder at 100 meters in this event.
One of the things that I think the Americans are forgetting here in this international competition is some of these other countries that have never had a chance to compete all of a sudden get a chance to swim next to a Steve Lundquist, like Andrew Phillips of Jamaica. He's inspired by the fact that he's ahead of Lundquist. And as we saw last night, John Sieben of Australia was inspired enough to win and break a world record in the 200 meters butterfly. So you can't really let somebody else take advantage of a situation. You've got to stick to your game plan and not just take it too easy.
There is a certain psychology involved here, particularly in the trials, when you're actually feeling your way toward a time that can make the final while still trying to conserve some energy, particularly late in the meet now, as many of these swimmers have swum various races to reach this point. As they come back from the freestyle leg, Lundquist has taken command. Andrew Phillips, highly motivated, trying to become the first man ever from Jamaica to make a final, is swimming right with Lundquist. They come down to the wall, the fastest previous time, 2:04.13. Lundquist touches in 2:06.10. Phillips touches in 2:06.43. And it will remain to be seen in both cases whether they will make the final. Lundquist now becomes the fourth fastest of those who have swum, and Phillips becomes the sixth fastest among those who have already swum. Alex Bauman is still yet to swim.